Hello friends, Honorable Vice Chancellor, Uttarakhand Open University, Professor O.P.S. Negi, Honorable Director, Commonwealth Educational Media Center for Asia, Professor Madhu Parar, Honorable UGC Chairman, Professor D.P. Singh Ji, he has given us his video message. Registrar of Uttarakhand Open University, Mr. Bharat Singh, Director, School of Computer Sciences and School of Vocational Education of Uttarakhand Open University, Professor Durgesh Pant Ji, my friend Jitendra Pandey Ji, and Gopal Ji, and my all colleagues from India, Bangladesh, and Sri Lanka. I am Dr. Manas Ranjan Panigrahi from Commonwealth Educational Media Center for Asia, New Delhi. In response to needs expressed by the Commonwealth countries of the Asian region for a more effective utilization of educational media resources for distance education, the Commonwealth of Learning Canada established Commonwealth Educational Media Center for Asia in the year 1994. This is an intergovernmental organization assisting governments and institutions to expand the scale, efficiency, and quality of learning by using multiple media in open, distance, and technology-enhanced learning. As you know that we are suffering from very crisis, that is, the COVID-19 pandemic has imposed multifarious challenges before the conventional and open and distance learning educational in higher education institutions across the globe. The learners face very difficulty to access the learning materials, reach their instructors and various stakeholders. The situation is more prominent for ODL institutions where large number of learners belonging to different socio-cultural background are enrolled. The present scenario compels the educational institutions to search and adopt innovative way to reach to their learners. Technology is the solution to address many of those challenges. There are various user-friendly technologies that could be adopted to teach and reach the learners. Considering this, SIMCA and Uttarakhand Open University organizing this 5-day online workshop on technology to reach and teach the learners from today to 25th May 2020. In this workshop, I can see here more than 100 participants are from Bangladesh, India, and Sri Lanka is participating. The workshop modality is three more pillar of the modality we are using here in the workshop. Uttarakhand Open University's LMS platform, which is Moodle based, and synchronous sessions every day for these 5 days, 1.5 hours, 10:30 to 12 p.m. in Indian standard time, and through the technology Zoom by the eminent resource persons. Asynchronous sessions will be every day covers through Moodle as well as WhatsApp group, which is created and all participants enroll into that. It's my great privilege that to introduce our resource persons, Professor Mustafa Azad Kamal from Bangladesh Open University, Bangladesh, Mr. Ashish Kumar Awadhia, from IGNU, Ajit Kumar, again from IGNU, Indira Gandhi National Open University, Dr. Nisha Singh from IGNU, and all the experts will be with us for all the 5 days, synchronously and asynchronously guide to us. With these words, I would like to invite Director SIMCA, Professor Madhu Pararji, addressed to this gathering. Professor Madhu Parar.
Thank you, Dr. Manas. Professor Negi, Vice Chancellor of Uttarakhand Open University. My colleagues, Professor Durgesh Pant from Uttarakhand Open University, Dr. Jitendra, all other colleagues from Uttarakhand Open University, my friends from Sri Lanka and Bangladesh, my colleagues from SEMCA, and all my experts which are going to be participating or presenting the subject matter or the content today in this five-day training program. So on behalf of SEMCA, I welcome all of you, especially Professor Negi, who took time from his busy schedule to attend this program and encourage us, SEMCA, to organize this program in collaboration with Uttarakhand Open University. Thank you so much, Professor Negi, firstly. Now, coming to the theme of this five-day program, Dr. Manas has planned that, and you know what is the schedule. But the only thing is we want to be that he said teachers, and all of you are teachers, it is very important for all of us to understand how technology can be applied in open and distance education or universities or institutions. Firstly, let me tell, I am also from an open university. This is for open universities, it is nothing new. All of us, we were doing such things before COVID. That's the mark which we are talking about, that COVID-19, suddenly everyone started saying, oh, go for online programs, we should use online platforms and so on and so forth. But open universities were already there and they were doing so many things to reach out to the learners, to reach out to their academic counselors and so on and so forth. It was actually this COVID-19 has shaken, if I use that word so, the formal system, the formal universities, because they were used to a face-to-face instruction. They were used to, except the IITs or IIMs and other universities, they were having face-to-face instruction, which is maybe they are right that was a part of the pedagogy which formal university is adopting. But open universities were far ahead from that. But this is an opportunity which created, we should not have that health crisis. So it was not something very good to have it. But through this, we established ourselves, the open universities established ourselves that we can do, and there are several ways people started accepting this mode of learning. Earlier, all of you know, and I have no this thing to say, that even the policymakers, they were saying, oh, what is open and distance education? What is online learning? But everyone, people, employers, parents, communities, everyone were not accepting this. Now, everyone has started accepting that online learning is going to be the future. So it is good that how do you integrate the technology into our system? That's very, very important part, very important aspect that we have to learn. And that's what this workshop, I'm sure this workshop is going to be very helpful. Now, where just few examples we'll take. What we can do in open university. So let's first take example of academic counseling. That's a very, very integral component aspect of our open system. How you are going to reach to the academic counselors? First step, we the teachers in open universities have to reach to the academic counselors. Academic counselors have to further reach to the students. Now, I was just thinking, like, let's take example of Uttarakhand Open University. You have several districts. One is Chamoli, one is Tehri, another is Dehradun, and so on and so forth. A student in Dehradun will definitely have access to many, many tools, the technology tools. Let's say in Chamoli, what tools are there? Can the student download? Is the internet there? Is the computer there? Point number one. If I take the example of Bangladesh, yesterday, such a big hurricane cyclone came, and you know what would have been the situation. At least West Bengal here in Orissa and Orissa states are devastated. So even the same is in Uttarakhand, because during the rainy seasons, all these districts, Tehri and Chamoli, students are not able to reach to the study centers. How do we have to reach there, and how academic counselors can support? So that's another important point. Examinations, that is another issue which UGC is asking, MHRD is asking, all formal universities are thinking that how to conduct these online examinations. So there is again groups divided. Some say it cannot be held, some say it can be held, NTA is doing it, and so on and so forth. So we need to see how we apply that. I will not take any other four examples, but very important is the distribution of the self-learning material, which has always been a point of concern for all open universities. Materials don't reach for whatever reasons. How can we do it? Like Uttarakhand Open University and several other open universities have done e-content. They have put it on their website. Now the point we have to see is next step. We have to have the learning analytics that how many they are downloading. From there we design, we develop our new strategies. So that's very important, and technology can support that. So I think in this 5 days program, we are going to do that. We are going to be the teachers. We are going to learn that how technology can be. Like I know Mr. Avidya is going to do that, how you can use, how teachers can use Google Classroom. I'm sure all of you must be knowing. It is not nothing new what we are learning, but maybe something new, or we can brush up our knowledge. So with these words, I thank all of you, especially thanks to Professor Negi for giving us the opportunity, and to Professor Durgesh Pant and Jiten Pandey, and of course my colleague Manas. Thank you so much, and I look forward to for this 5 days. Of course, I will also be attending this 5 days program. All the best, and thank you once again.
Thank you very much, Professor Parar, for your very nice words and encouraging words in this particular situation. And now I would like to request Professor Durgesh Pant to deliver his address from NSOU site, at Uttarakhand Open University site. Sorry. Professor Durgesh Pant.
Very good morning to you all, and very eminent Honorable Vice Chancellor of Uttarakhand Open University, Professor O.P.S. Negi, Chief Guest Professor T.P. Singh, Chairman UGC, very learned Professor Madhu Bahar, Director SEMCA, Dr. Manas, Dr. Jitendra, Dr. Gopal, participants from India, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, and cyclone, as Professor Parha said, cyclone Amphan. It has hit this Calcutta, Bangladesh, but thankfully things are under control, like pandemic COVID-19. So most of already it has been stated, Dr. Manas and Dr. Parha, they have already spoken about it. But this workshop has been organized while our planet is in the grip of this pandemic 19, for sure. But this COVID moment, which has, you know, turned this entire planet, now it is more volatile, it is complex, it is ambiguous, and there is a lot of uncertainty. So these are various factors which has somehow engripped our and encapsulated our planet. And we were not knowing about it. Did anyone of us ever expect that this pandemic is going to hit 7.5 billion people in this planet? So this is something unprecedented which has happened. So now the world is changing. It does mean that socio-behavioral pattern, educational, everything, it is changing. How it is changing from this brick and it would change, as Dr. Parhar was saying, ODL system, open universities, they were already doing it, many, many things they were doing. But from this brick and mortar model to this digital space that now we are embracing and world at large is embracing, this is also very true. From social gathering, as we say, from social gathering, it is more, you know, this social distancing. When we say social distancing, at times we mean to say this is physical distancing. From offline, online is, you know, something is happening. From physical, it is virtual, and from this cerebral, it is more cyber. So it is this transformation is there. And two, three things, very important things that happened suddenly in the wake of this COVID-19. That suddenly technology is our new religion. Everywhere, all around, with boundaries, technology is our new religion. Work from home, we are all sitting, you know, either in our office spaces, because now it is slowly, slowly opening up. Otherwise, work from home, it becomes our new culture, and it has indeed become. Social distancing is the new norm. Wearing mask is now essential. Otherwise, it never was. Now it is essential. So there are many new things. And virtual is more real than real. So it is happening. And one very important thing that has happened, especially for Southeast Asia, this one is, we used to consume many natural resources. So this consumptive lifestyle that we have, now it is slowly leading to sort of frugal lifestyle, it is happening. So this is something unprecedented which is happening. No two opinions that again we got to live with the COVID-19. This is not something that government will come someday and announce that COVID-19 is over. This is not going to happen ever. We know this. There was flu, there was malaria, there was this thing, n number of things, but we got to live with it. Yes, there shall be medicine, there shall be other things like this, but we have to cope with it. But somehow humanity has survived over millennia. There were so many times of disasters, but we have overcome. But one very important thing being, and which is the highlight of this workshop also, that while there are these challenges, and there are opportunities also. So how these opportunities, especially, and Dr. Madhubarar also indicated, what it has done is somehow it has accelerated so many processes altogether. We used to, every time round, we used to talk about technology enabled education, School of Computer Science. In fact, at UOU, it did implement many things and a decade back. But for policymakers, in order to understand these things, it's very, very difficult. But somehow it has fast forwarded everything. What was not happening in 5 years' time, 10 years' time, now it is happening within these times. Unprecedented. And today's workshop, therefore, it encapsulates many such online educational tools and techniques. We were talking about it. You see, 1.37 billion people and students across the globe, they are limited to home. And 60.2 million faculty members, they are no longer in class. Now, this is an extraordinary situation. This huge number, this around education, our entire civilization hinges. So in this regard, in this scenario, this faculty members, entire academic ecosystem, it is trying to find out a new model of teaching learning, which could eventually, shift from top-down lecturing and passive student to sort of more interactive, collaborative approach in which students and teacher will co-create. So this workshop, again, will lead to this co-creation. This is the essence of this workshop. And it is holistic because it will help and empower participants. Wherever they are, again, there are no boundaries, global it is. So technological tools and these things and pedagogies, especially for teaching, learning, and classroom engagement and the strategies, will be taken up. Now, one very important point that I would just like to take up, because as Dr. Farhar was saying, this is because there are teachers now. Teachers are part of this workshop. We all know about, this Bloom's taxonomy. We have all being raised with this Bloom's taxonomy, how from knowledge, how this learning takes place from knowledge, and finally this is going up. Earlier it used to be evaluation, but this is part of this cognitive domain. And later on, subsequently, when it was revised, we said, it is remembering. From noun, it got shifted to verb. From the noun to action-oriented, dynamic it became. So it was more or less, from remembering and finally to creating. This technology thing, what has happened is, it has done this thing, it has accelerated, it has given a new pace to it. And now this is digital Bloom's taxonomy. And if you look at the content of this workshop spread over 5 days, you will realize as to how it is happening from this remembering part to creating part, from this basic Googling what, when, where, these kinds of, and further on going up, and finally leading to reading. Dr. Nisha Singh, while she would be doing something of that sort, you realize again analytics she was talking about, how we can do this part. So this is higher order thinking. So at times I call it from lords to hordes. This is no order thinking to higher order thinking. This is this paradigm shift is. This is something very important with regard to this workshop. Because all the workshop I was going through all 5 days, from introduction to Google, Larry Page and Sergey Brin, they would have never thought this day, only some 25 years back while they were students together, to this day when we will be talking about only these things. And to what this mind mapping, to what basically OER, and to basically social media based. So all these points, these are finer points, and those will be taken up part of this thing. Yes, AI, other things, analytics. So those things are again very important. And if, because our vice chancellor, he's very, very keen, very active. In fact, he is a big push, and he keeps telling us a big catalyst that you keep doing this. So maybe we can pick up all these issues. And very interesting part being UNESCO, the highest apex body of the world, United Nations, this one, body. And recently, and amid this COVID-19, it has recommended several programs and MOOCs to all those applications, from Edmodo to EdRed to A-Step to Google Classroom, Moodle, and UNESCO is proposing, UNESCO is saying, please go through and please have, and these are safe ones. So when it's the world order from UN and to the local level everywhere it is happening, I think it has just set the stage very, very right. And the School of Computer Science, since we have always taken initiatives with regard to these ones, and also so many programs under the School of Vocational Studies that we also, under the able leadership of our Vice Chancellor, that we want to start off with so many programs. He will deliberate as to how many different programs, vocational programs, especially for school teachers, from for other researchers, so that they could be in sync with technology enabled education. So this is the need of our, and I wish everybody all the best, because we are part of it. We will remain with this. And as Dr. Madhu Parar was saying, you know, School of Computer is very important, because not only in terms of this university system, but since we are catering to entire state, at the moment I have also been given responsibility of science education research of the state. So we are contributing in a big way, but open university is there, the backbone. So what we can do with SENCA, what we can do with, because they are all our ambassadors now, in Sri Lanka and Bangladesh, all around, everywhere. So it is a welcome platform. We have created it and we will take it forward. This is a magnificent one. I wish all the participants good luck. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Professor Pant, your nice words and explaining and introducing about this 5 days workshop and its output and outcome and utilization in particular this the not only just in the crisis but also in the regularizing and mainstreaming of education through blended online and distance mode. Thank you very much, sir. On due respect, Professor OPS Negi, Vice Chancellor, Uttarakhand Open University, and Professor Madhu Parar, Director SEMCA. With your kind permission, I would like to play the video, which is sent by University Grant Commission, Government of India Chairman Professor D.P. Singh Ji, and addressing and encouraging to this 5 days workshop. So with your permission, I am playing this one.
Namaskar, Professor O.P.S. Negi, Honorable Vice Chancellor of Uttarakhand Open University, Haldwani, Professor Madhu Parahar, Director CMCA, Professor Durgesh Pant, convener of the workshop, Dr. Jitendra Pandey, coordinator of the workshop, all the delegates from Bangladesh, Sri Lanka and India, faculty members, ladies and gentlemen. It gives me immense pleasure to inaugurate the workshop on a highly relevant topic, COVID-19, technology to reach and teach the learners today. And thank Professor Negi for inviting me to this occasion. Friends, we all know that COVID-19 has taken a heavy toll on all walks of life globally. During lockdown period, in most parts of the world, including India, educational institutions have been closed. In India alone, more than 32 crore students have been affected. Globally, this pandemic has changed the way people live, behave, and act. Social distancing or physical distancing has become the new norm. But we have to have resilience to fight it and keep moving towards making our planet a better place to live. This complex and volatile situation provides us newer opportunities also. We know for sure that this entire human civilization more or less hinges around education and the value system that we transfer from one generation to another. In this context, I am very happy to know that the School of Computer Science and IT and Vocational Studies of Uttarakhand Open University, in collaboration with Commonwealth Educational Media Center for Asia, New Delhi, is organizing a 5-day workshop, especially pertaining to the online tools which are required for dissemination of online education and has become indispensable in the wake of COVID-19. I extend my compliments to Uttarakhand Open University and the collaborating institution for this endeavor. It is important during these days of social distancing that our system embraces digital teaching learning methods comprehensively and develop an academic ecosystem in which our learners and teachers could be in sync with the technological tools and techniques. When face-to-face engagement is to be avoided, technology can provide us a platform through which learners and teachers could not only be benefited, but they could also make use of the best available teaching learning resources. With the digital web, the knowledge boundaries are thinning, and the learner, wherever he or she is, has an opportunity to get the best of the contents from the best of the teachers at his or her own learning pace, place, and time. The power of technology has diminished many boundaries and at the same time accelerated the teaching learning process. This is the other side of COVID-19. It is in this context that this digital workshop assumes greater significance. I have also got to know that it covers various topics like Google tools, CMS, LMS, etc., which are very important for teachers, researchers, and learners. You all would be happy to know that the UGC has taken a number of measures to meet the challenges arising out of the COVID-19. To ensure uninterrupted teaching and learning at home and minimize academic loss by leveraging the potential of ICT, UGC advised the universities to shift to online mode of teaching during the lockdown period. It also shared with universities the links of digital platforms developed by MHRD and UGC to create awareness among the academic fraternity. The universities are being encouraged to make use of ICT initiatives like SWAM online courses, UG, PG MOOCs, EPG Pathshala, SWAM Prabha, CEC UGC YouTube channel, National Digital Library, Shodh Ganga, eShodh Sindhu, and Vidwan database, etc. It is truly heartening to see that the traffic on the SWAM portal has increased multifold during these days. UGC has also notified open and distance learning and online regulations. And as of now, 128 universities for 1,592 ODL programs and 7 universities for 37 online programs have been recognized by UGC. As of now, a total of around 45 lakh learners are enrolled under ODL mode. The online education is likely to get a further boost with the recent announcement of Honorable Finance Minister and also to permit top 100 universities to offer online programs. A number of suggestions have been received under Bharat Padhe online campaign, which was launched by our Honorable Minister for Human Resource Development, Dr. Ramesh Pokhriyal Ji Nishank. Thus, the share of online education is going to increase soon. And workshop like this will prove of great help to popularize this mode, since the success of technology-enabled education depends on the capacity building of our faculty members. In the end, I congratulate all the participants and the organizers, Uttarakhand Open University and Commonwealth Educational Media Center for Asia. I do hope that Uttarakhand Open University and the Commonwealth Educational Media Center for Asia will keep developing better and enriching models and techniques to facilitate large number of learners who definitely deserve better quality education in the wake of COVID-19 and in the post-COVID era. I wish you all healthy and safe living. I wish the workshop a grand success and great learning time for all the participants. Thank you and Jai Hind.
Now I would like to request Honorable Vice Chancellor Uttarakhand Open University, Professor O.P.S. Negi, to give the presidential address and blessings to all participants and success of this important workshop. Professor O.P.S. Negi.
I wish you.
Namaskar. Good morning, everybody. Greeting from the Uttarakhand Open University, Haldwani. The chief guest of this inaugural session of online workshop on the COVID-19 technology to reach and teach the learners, Honorable Chairman, University Grant Commission, Professor D.P. Singh Ji, Director of SIMCA, Professor Madhu Prahar Ji, panelist, my colleague, Professor Durgesh Panji, Director, School of Computer Science, IT and Vocational Studies of Uttarakhand Open University, Dr. Manas Panigarehi, Dr. Jiten Pandey, Academic Administrative Staff of the Uttarakhand Open University, panel experts from India and abroad, the distinguished participants from India, Bangladesh, and Sri Lanka, media personnel who are joining it, ladies and gentlemen. This is the crucial time of COVID-19 pandemic, it has significantly disrupted the higher education sectors. 90% of the world's student population is out of the school due to this pandemic. The way of our government, institutions, organizations, and people think and function will change drastically. Distance and online learning has attained the importance of as the only means of the education institutions to keep the doors of learning open. This time, the students are adopting the online learning via different online platforms. The teachers are using various online tools like YouTube, Google Classroom, Microsoft, Facebook, etc. And there are many kinds of the course delivery. The students understand the importance of continuing education. This time, the ODL, the open and distance learning, has become the important in comparison to the face-to-face education. India is now to online education mode. Many private and government institutions in the country had been conducting online classes. Uttarakhand Open University imparts education through open and distance learning. We had started the interactive mode of the education with EduSet way back in the first decade of 2000. Our university adopted online education around 2010. Now we have a full-fledged Moodle-based platform to deliver online education. The School of Computer Science, under the able leadership of my colleague, Dr. Professor Durgesh Panji, is conducting online counseling, and most of the courses are available in the online format. Our research department is nowadays conducting the PhD coursework in blended mode. The School of Computer and Management, School of the Commerce and Management has now started online education program. Now it's a high time for all the teachers to adopt these practices. I congratulate Professor Durgesh Panji, Dr. Jitendra Pandey, and their team for organizing this international capacity building workshop for the academicians of the Uttarakhand Open University, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka, with the coordination of the support of Professor Madhu Parharji, Manas Ji of SIMCA. I hope this workshop will cover various modes of the technologies to facilitate online delivery. Of course, start courses starting from Google Tools, Learning Management System, FOSS Tools for Online Delivery, OERs, and the other effective use of the social media for the course delivery. I hope this workshop will open a new window for the open and distance learning and will force the society to look towards the online education and the open education. I want to take this opportunity to thank Professor Madhu Parharji, Dr. Manas Panigariji, and other colleagues of SIMCA for necessary support for conducting this workshop. Last but not the least, I express my deepest sense of the gratitude and thanks to our honorable chief guest, the chairman of the University Grant Commission, Professor D.P. Singh Ji, for sparing his valuable time to deliver the inaugural address, along with the blessings, inspiring inputs, and motivation for the learners. I am quite confident that this five-day workshop will be useful and beneficial to the online learners and will be a milestone to achieve the goals of today's education towards the blended learning. I am sure that by the end of this workshop, the faculty members attending this program will find new ways, new tools, new technology to reach and teach the learners through online mode. my best wishes for the grand success of the workshop. Thank you very much. Jai.
Thank you, Professor Negi. Thanks a lot for the kind words.
Thank you, madam.
Thank you very much, Honorable Vice Chancellor, Professor O.P.S. Negi, for your kind, motivating words and trust on the organizers and our collaboration, as well as extending words towards the new partners, new collaboration among the three countries, Bangladesh, India, Sri Lanka, moving towards the educational development and bringing the new inputs to the new education system with quality and integrated education system in these three countries. Thank you very much, sir, for your kind words. Now I would like to invite Dr. Jitendra Pandey.
Honorable Chairman of UGC, Professor D.P. Singh, in absentia, Honorable Vice Chancellor of Uttarakhand Open University, respected Professor Madhu Prahar, Director Simca, convener of the workshop, Professor Durgesh Pant, Mr. Bharat Singh, Registrar, Uttarakhand Open University, our most valued invited experts, ladies and gentlemen. It's my privilege to have been asked to propose a vote of thanks on this occasion. I, on behalf of Uttarakhand Open University, our partner Simca, and on my own behalf, extend a very heartily vote of thanks to all speakers for gracing the occasion and sharing with us your findings and opinions today. First of all, I would like to propose heartily vote of thanks to our chief guest, Professor D.P. Singh, Honorable Chairman UGC, for gracing the workshop. Thank you, sir, for your very interesting and thought-provoking address. I would also like to thank our Vice Chancellor, Professor Negi, for his presence, guidance, and support at every level. I am very grateful to Professor Madhu Prahar for giving us this opportunity to organize this event. I would also like to thank our beloved Professor Durgesh Pant for his address, moral support, and guidance. I would like to thank all the respected experts who have blessed us with their presence. I would also like to thank our partner Simca for providing support for organizing this event. Finally, I again want to thank our registrar, Mr. Bharat Singh, and all those organizing teams, especially Dr. Manas, Dr. Gopal, and our ICT team. I would like to thank all the participants making this event a success. I wish you all a great learning experience. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Jitendra Pandey.